college textbooks should be free for, you know, college students. Let's see. I'm credible to speak on this topic because not only am I a college student, but I've done research on this topic, and I feel like all of you can relate to this topic as well. Let's see. My thesis is college textbooks should be free for college students on the ground that our tuition costs keep rising, the textbook is overpriced, and considering there are other alternatives to just getting a textbook, like the internet is always free, there should be like a lowering, if not free, make the college textbooks free, so I worked that out.
Sure.
And to start this off, just show a quick video.
If there was one thing I remember about university, was how freaking tedious it was to acquire textbooks, let alone affordable ones. When I say affordable, I mean something that I can purchase and not immediately say, wow, guess who's not eating for the next 17 days? I always hated the start of a new semester because I look back on how short the previous one was and realize how much money I wasted on books, half of which I knew I was never going to use again. Prior to the new semester, or on the first day, you'd get a course syllabus with a list of books you're required to buy. What I hated seeing was when there was like 3 books for the mandatory list, and then an additional 23 in a recommended list. Are you kidding me? It's like, hey, you need these books to pass and do well, but if you really want to make my dick hard and go above and beyond, buy these books, even though you obviously don't have enough time to read 3/4 of them before the exam. Another thing I hated was how specific they sometimes were about the edition of the book. Like,
sir, the 5th and 6th edition of this book is practically the same.
The same? Oh, Mr. Peters, you poor big guy too. As you can see in the 5th edition, in chapter 12 of page 394, the picture of the caterpillar is monochromatic, while the 6th edition is in color, and is instead of the 3rd leaf from the right. So get the right edition, or get out of my class. Then you look at the prices of these books at your school store, and it's like, damn, son. These better be made out of dragon scales and printed in unicorn blood. Don't bend them. So you end up looking for alternatives. Looking for stores that sell used books, asking older students for their no longer needed copies, chipping in for one book and sharing it with your classmates, etc.
So the problem with you know, textbooks obviously is that they're so expensive, right? Like, according to USnews.com, on average, the average student pays about $1,200 a year on supplies, you know, textbooks, notebooks, so on and so forth, right? And so that's honestly due to like textbook industries. Again, according to US News, the textbook industry has grown 82% in the last 2 years. So back then, textbooks were cheaper, and now they just skyrocket and go into like crazy prices, right? Another problem is that, let's see, as most of you probably know, our tuition keeps rising, right? You'll see flyers around the school saying, oh, tuition is going up, but our professors aren't being paid, or this and that, yaddy yaddy. Well, aside from that, with our tuition going up, it's also getting harder to buy these textbooks, right? And according to the HuffingtonPost.com, the cost of college degree has gone up 1,120% in the last 30 years. And in community colleges, it's gone up like roughly 8% compared to four-year universities, where it's gone up like 12%. Again, Huffington Post. Quick preview of my main points. First, I'll be addressing the problem, as I already said, sorry. The problems, the causes to this topic, and of course the solutions to it. As I've already discussed the problems, we need to move on to the causes of it. So a few causes of it are just plain and simple, the instructor who asks or encourages the students to buy these books, right? Specifically for this class, I did not feel comfortable throwing $50 on the book that I was only going to use once. This is Communications with 50, general ed class. All the students have to take it, and I didn't feel right to just buy a book that I'll only use once, right? I managed to find the book online as a PDF, I was lucky enough. So if you give enough time and resources, you can find it online or something similar to it. Let's see, another problem, is that, of course, the textbook stores such as Barnes & Noble, like one we have on campus, again, with the high prices, and there are even some books in those bookstores that you can't even resell. Like, for example, this book, if you're to buy it, you have to pull out the worksheets, right? I'm not sure if you can even sell it because the book isn't complete, but even if so, you did sell it, the person who bought it can't really use it because you pulled out the worksheets, right? So that kind of doesn't really work well, you know? It doesn't make sense. Now that I've discussed the causes, just like to move over to this chart over here. I should have enlarged it more, but pretty much it's discussing the price of, you know, education. The textbooks have gone up about 80% as I mentioned from the US News. And then, you know, comparing it to other things like medical services, that's only gone up in the past few years about 57%. And, you know, just a slight comparison, you know, why do textbooks cost more than, you know, medical supplies, right? Here's another picture for you, how the 800% rise in textbooks over the past 30 years. Let's see. According to the usnews.com, about 65% of students choose not to buy a textbook on the grounds that it's too expensive. And of the 65%, 95% of students are very like stressed out on how this will immediately affect their grade in class, right? Because, you know, they don't have a book. But they're still choosing not to take it because, you know, it's too expensive to buy a book. Let's see. Again, US News. Of course, the immediate solution to this would just to make textbooks free for all college students, right? You know, going through our classes, we're moving from quarters to semesters. So in quarters, we could take like 3 classes and boom, that's our 12 units. Now we gotta take 4 classes to make 12 units, you know? And they're changing up the schedule, so instead of just taking easy like Monday, Wednesday classes, some classes have changed to Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and some of us have Friday off, so, you know, now I have to come to school Friday, and it kind of feels like high school again. And so, now that I've discussed the problem, the causes, and some solutions to it, I'd like to restate my thesis, which is textbooks should be free for college students on the grounds our tuition keeps rising, the prices are outrageous, and the monopoly held over them are not really understandable compared to other necessities and fees that are in our, you know, current economy. And to close my speech, I have a quote by Mark Twain that goes, "In the first place, God made idiots, and that was for practice. Then he made school boards.